chilling on the laid-back island of Kirkin is the regular old village of Rosenboden. Our main gal, Reisalin Stout, is kinda over the whole routine of being a run-of-the-mill farmer's kid. Trying to spice things up, Reza's dealing with the daily grind on the farm, like wrestling with Kirkin fruits. It ain't a walk in the park, but her dad's all about pushing through, preaching the gospel of hard work and island traditions. Ryza's daydreaming about the Fairystone Forest, picturing a life beyond the island's borders. A visit from a merchant stirs up some curiosity, hinting that there might be more to life than the village bubble. In a total spur-of-the-moment move, Ryza throws caution to the wind and decides to go on a wild adventure, totally shaking up the village norms. The arrival of an outsider and the allure of the forbidden west side of the highway fuel her rebellious spirit. Ryza and her crew set sail on a less-than-ideal boat, officially kicking off their adventure. It's a middle finger to tradition, and they're all about embracing the unknown for a life that's anything but ordinary. With a mix of excitement and determination, they venture into uncharted territories, ignoring the warnings from the island's wise old folks. Ryza's dream of finding something rad and conquering distant towers becomes the force behind their risky journey. Unexpected obstacles pop up, like island authorities being party poopers and discovering incomplete maps. It's a reminder that this adventure gig ain't all sunshine and rainbows. Ryza's resilience and her squad's backup show that true adventure ain't for the faint of heart. Picture this. The gang's cruising down what seems like a regular path when bam! They stumble upon a giant mushroom and meet Claudia, this mysterious girl who's about to kickstart one heck of an adventure. As they wander through the lush forest, the gang faces a surprise round of monster madness. Reisa, Lent, and Tao get into a showdown, flexing their determination and teamwork muscles. But wait! In swoops Claudia, their mysterious savior, introducing them to the mystical world of alchemy. In a sneaky forest hideout, Claudia spills the beans on alchemy's secrets. Turns out, it's not just about patching up wounds. It's a whole world of endless possibilities. Guided by Claudia, the gang rolls into the sweet village of Rosenboden. They meet Empel and Lila, who roll out the red carpet. Mr. Moritz, the big boss of the village, has some secrets up his sleeve, and our crew becomes the village VIPs. Claudia sees Riza's got mad potential for alchemy. With Claudia as the guide, Reisa takes her first dive into the alchemy scene, cracking open mysteries and discovering her hidden talent. Despite the hurdles and doubts, Ryza owns it as an alchemist, whipping up her first alchemical item, a supplement. The crew throws a party to celebrate Ryza's newfound skills, kicking off an epic journey into the alchemy realms. It's not just a test of skill, it's a measure of how committed she is to this craft. Ryza's mentor takes things up a notch, pushing her to explore beyond the island. Mapping and terrain understanding become the real deal, adding a dash of realism to this alchemical journey. Now, it's not just about mixing potions. It's about mastering a bunch of skills. The hunt for the elusive Serenity Flower becomes the main plot twist. Ryza's dead set on finding it, leading her to explore the wilds. The game changes as Ryza sets up her own alchemist lab, the Atelier. It's a move from hitting the to Ryza's alchemy. Picture Ryza staring out at the ocean, pondering her treasures and moments that hit right in the feels. She's musing about time flying and how we only fully get the feels for stuff when they're not around. It's like a big realization moment, you know? Ryza bumps into Claudia, and they bond over alchemy and rekindling old friendships. Together, they dive into the magic of past gifts, turning memories into some real-deal connections. Here's the fun part. Ryza and the crew go on a mission to recreate this epic scent tied to Mrs. Barbara's past. Thanks to alchemy, they uncover forgotten links and bring joy to everyone's lives. As they dig deeper into the source of that long-lost fragrance, the gang unravels how their lives are all tangled up and how those little gestures from way back when still matter big time. The story spills the beans on alchemy being not just about making cool stuff, but also about building deeper connections. Things get emotional when Claudia spills her love for music. In this heartwarming moment, the squad realizes that true friendship is like a fine wine. It only gets better with time. Ryza's crew, with Lent and Tao in tow, get surprised on their journey. Lent, bogged down with farm duties, spills about the struggle of juggling alchemy with life. Empel and Lila swoop in, summoning them for a special mission that's got everyone's curiosity buzzing. Lila spills the beans, and their test is taking them to a place called the Sunken Mine. Lent, Ryza, and Tao gotta dive into the depths of this mysterious cave and make it back in one piece. It's a clear challenge, but what dangers lurk in there? No one knows. Before the big trip, Empel drops some wisdom. Lent gets a pep talk about making solid decisions, and Tao's reminded to roll with the punches. The training vibes hit hard as they gear up for the journey ahead. Off they go, navigating the sunken mine's lit-up cavern. The excitement's real, but the chill atmosphere makes them wonder if some serious monsters are lurking. Lila's picked a dangerous test, and caution is the name of the game. Deeper into the cave, they bump into a stone monster. A total surprise. Ryza's problem-solving skills get put to the test as she hunts for the needed ore. Out of nowhere, a bomb goes off, turning things wild and upping the danger level in the cavern. The chaos makes them think about what this journey really means. Lent, Ryza, and Tao face unexpected hurdles, putting their teamwork to the ultimate test. In the face of danger, they learn some big lessons about trust, prep, and facing the consequences of their moves. Ryza's alchemy mojo accidentally sets off a major explosion, proving that actions have consequences. Empel jumps in, stressing the need to get the quality and power of synthesized items. He's all about avoiding reckless moves that could put lives on the line. The incident becomes a game changer for Ryza, making her think about the responsibility that comes with her alchemy skills. The gang makes it out of the cave a bit shaken, but still kicking, signaling the end of carefree experimenting and the start of a more thoughtful alchemy approach. So, picture this concerned dude rolling up to Ryza, spilling the tea about how her and the crew are acting all weird after their sunken mine gig. It's clear that the whole experience left them shook, and now they're itching to sort things out. To ease the tension, the gang cooks up a genius plan: water training. Led by the mysterious Lila, they set out to face their fears and level up their skills. Little did they know, this seemingly simple idea was about to spark some serious personal growth. As our crew tackles their water unease, Ryza drops a bomb about her fear. But with her friends, especially Claudia, giving her the boost, Ryza takes the plunge into some seriously quirky challenges, including the legendary underwater puny jumps. What started as a chill training day turns into a full-on teamwork test. They're thrown into challenges like hunting for hidden stuff and bagging a massive kirkin fruit, learning the real deal about teamwork. Trial and error teach them that having each other's back is key. Under Empel's watchful eye, the gang gets pushed to the max. He tosses challenges their way that need both solo skills and group hustle. It's like a journey mirroring life's ups and downs, showing that facing problems together is the way to go. As they tackle Lila's challenges, the gang stumbles onto a plan to create a secret hideout. It's not just a cool idea. It's a symbol of their shared adventures and a beacon of hope, a spot to retreat to when things get real. Our leader, the energetic Reisalin Stout, kicks things off by sharing the gang's dream of a special spot where they can just do their thing. Alchemist Guru Empel boosts their spirits, telling them to imagine the whole place like a super cool concoction. He's all about the power of imagination and trusting those gut feelings. Ryza takes charge, diving into the challenge of sketching out the hideout. They brainstorm everything: an alchemy zone, a workout area, a chill reading nook, and even a wooden deck for some tea sipping. But let's be real, decoding Ryza's doodles isn't a walk in the park, and the gang has to put in work to bring her vision to life. To build their dream hideout, they need materials, and here comes a curveball. A local goat raiser named Basila unexpectedly steps in to lend a hand. They make a deal. Ryza promises a recipe for a snack that tastes like happiness in return for the help. Claudia, the merchant's daughter, takes on the challenge of whipping up a tasty snack using goat milk. It's a roller coaster of trials, errors, and a blind taste test. The gang teams up, showing off their unique skills and strengthening their bonds. After some serious experimenting, Claudia hits the jackpot and crafts a mouth-watering pudding. It becomes the island's special treat, showcasing the gang's dedication and their mission to turn their hideout into a joy-filled place. Just when they're close to finishing their hideout, bam! A massive, mysterious monster pops up, throwing everyone into a bit of a panic. But instead of backing down, they decide to face it head-on, proving they've got the guts and a newfound team spirit. Empel and Lila, the alchemy pros, step up and offer to stick around as watchdogs to protect the island from any potential threats. The gang learns the importance of staying cautious and keeping their hideout safe. In a deep thought moment, Claudia starts thinking about life. She's had this lightbulb moment about how what really matters isn't things, but the people you've got around you. True treasures, she figures, only shine when they're not around. Guess what? Claudia's got the itch for adventure now. She's all pumped to tag along with Ryza and the crew on their quests. This leads her to hit up Ryza for some archery lessons, showing she's ready to jump into the action. Hold up. We're taking a detour into Fashion Town. Claudia gets dragged into this dress thing by a traveling merchant named Romy. It's all fun and games, with Ryza reluctantly joining in, proving there's more to their lives than just quests. There's a sprinkle of fashion and fantasy. Time to get practical with alchemy. Their hideout springs a leak thanks to that earthquake. Claudia's dad throws down a challenge for Ryza and the gang to fix it, turning it into a surprise test of their alchemical skills. The gang rocks it and sorts out the leak, showing that alchemy isn't just about potions but can handle real-world issues. But hold on, Claudia's dad hints there's more crazy stuff coming their way, keeping our adventurers on their toes. Claudia's all about adventure, but her dad's not fully on board. The story dives into the relationship dance between Claudia, her pops, and Ryza's crew, adding layers to their connections. It's not just about facing external challenges. There's some serious internal growth and understanding going on. Things take a wild twist as Claudia deals with Boss, a character throwing shade at their adventures. Ryza and the gang decide to face it head-on, ready to prove themselves and score some personal growth points. So, Riza's on a mission to show off her alchemical chops, and the village is looking for something exciting. Mr. Lubart sets up a challenge. Clean up a trashy spot in a week. Sounds simple, right? But there's more to it than meets the eye. The village square has turned into a dump site, causing a headache for everyone. Ryza and her pals get the gig to use alchemy to clean up. What seems like a regular chore becomes a test not just of alchemical skills, but also of understanding what the community needs. Ryza, armed with her alchemy knowledge, suggests using bombs to blow away the trash. But hold up, a light bulb goes off. Blowing stuff up in a residential area might not be the smartest move. It's a moment of truth for Ryza as she rethinks her plan and considers the bigger picture. To find a safer solution, Ryza turns to the alchemy guru, Empel. He hooks her up with a high-level alchemical recipe book. This isn't just about learning. It's about teamwork and mentorship in the alchemical world. With this new knowledge, Ryza gets her hands dirty, experimenting with alchemical recipes. She adds a touch of luft to her bombs, and after some creative chaos, boom, trash gone, no harm done. But guess what? This wasn't the end game. Mr. Pat spills the beans. More tests are coming. These trials are a way for the villagers to see the real-life perks of alchemy, beyond just blowing stuff up. Throughout the challenges, Ryza's squad has her back. Lent, Tao, and Claudia stick by her side. Even the skeptics, like Mr. Pat, start realizing that alchemy is the real deal for the village. As the story unfolds, unexpected stuff pops up. Agatha needs Ryza's alchemical mojo to fix a fancy ornament, showing that alchemy's not just practical, it's downright magical. Claudia's got some deep thoughts too, hinting at understanding her dad's moves. As the crew shoots the breeze about a mysterious scout and its forest shenanigans, the conversation gets real. They're on to something fishy about the ominous castle chilling on the mountain. Speculations and suspicions start flying, adding a dash of intrigue to the mix. Now, things get spicy as the gang gears up for the ultimate challenge set by Claudia's old man. It's a high-speed highway race with surprises like monster face-offs. The vibe turns competitive, setting the stage for a roller coaster of an adventure. Hold on to your hats, because out of the blue, a dragon decides to crash the party. Both racing teams now face a fiery, scaly situation. The showdown with the dragon turns the episode into an action-packed roller coaster. Talk about adding urgency to the storyline. Hold on to your mystery hats, because the gang discovers a weird glowing stone with cryptic text. Clues point towards a summoning device in the castle, suggesting the dragon might be part of a grand plan. Unraveling these riddles becomes the gang's next big mission. After the dragon showdown, the gang's dealing with the aftermath. Some of them need patching up, and the whole incident triggers deep reflections. They're thinking hard about the consequences of their dragon dance and the safety of their village. To tackle the dragon threat, the gang gets their heads together to cook up a mega bomb. Empel and Ryza are brainstorming how to level up their arsenal. Crafting becomes a symbol of their grit to protect the village and conquer whatever comes their way. The crew sets out on a suspenseful quest to track down the monster behind the dragon drama. The pursuit of the unknown and the thirst for answers push the storyline forward, showcasing the gang's guts and grit. In the middle of the chaos, everyone's got their opinions on this dragon. Is it a guardian angel or a fire-breathing menace? The villagers are split on whether to hug it out or take it down. Boss goes all in for dragon hunting, but not everyone's sold on this risky plan. Boss is like, "Let's do this, folks." He's pulling together a dragon hunting posse, getting some cheers and side eyes from the locals. The whole thing gets messy as the village tries to figure out how to deal with this beastly situation. With the big shots like Empel and Lila MIA, the village is on its own. But Reisa steps up, waving her alchemical wand like a boss. She's got a secret weapon up her sleeve, bringing a fresh twist to the story. As the village preps for dragon hunting, unexpected alliances pop up. Reisa, Claudia, Tao, and Lent put their differences aside and form a dream team. The idea of a crazy journey brings them together, proving that strength is in numbers. Ryza's alchemy game is on point. She whips up tools to tackle roadblocks on the way to the dragon's crib. Alchemy becomes the hero, showing how creativity can shine in the face of chaos. We get a quick peek into Ryza's family vibes as she chats with her pops. The love and worry for family add a real touch to the dragon saga, making it more than just a fantastical ride. Ryza, the alchemy queen, steps into the limelight. She's got skills, and she ain't shy about it. The gang's banking on her to work her alchemy magic, especially as they approach that cliff hanging around the castle. As they stroll through the forest, the crew gets all nostalgic, remembering the good old days. Tao's got his detective hat on, keeping an eye out for monster clues, even though Empel's hot on that monster trail. Now, this cliff ain't your regular cliff. It's a problem. Ryza whips out her latest alchemical masterpiece, Luft, a wind power champ. With a dash of creativity, they breeze past the obstacle, making cliffs look like child's play. Once they hit the castle, it's like a scene out of a fantasy movie. Battle scars everywhere, and a mysterious rock with ancient doodles. Ryza gets her detective hat on and cracks some of the code, linking the dragon, some summoning mojo, and a dude named Felosha. The gang's brainstorming on this summoning thing, and it's linked to the dragon rampage. Tao deciphers the magic word, Felosha, and spills the beans about finding glowing text rocks to amp up their dragon showdown. It's showtime! The gang dives into an epic battle with the dragon, pulling off moves straight out of the ancient stone playbook. Teamwork, strategy, and a sprinkle of magic. They conquer the beast. Post-dragon smackdown, they're on cloud nine, patting themselves on the back. Not everyone's thrilled. Some villagers are partying, while others give them the stink eye. The gang's brave, but not exactly the village favorites. The villagers are all thanks, Ryza! And even Mr. Moritz gives them the green light to island hop whenever they please. Freedom unlocked. But, not everyone's a fan of dragon slaying. The elder's not happy, and there's some village drama brewing. Despite the scolding and mixed vibes from parents and villagers, our gang's got their eyes on the prize. In the middle of the daily grind, Mr. Fresher stumbles on a grubby stone tablet. Surprise, surprise, It's not just junk. Talks start bubbling about these dusty tablets having more to them than meets the eye. Empel and Lila get a hero's welcome after taking down the dragon. But hold up. There's a new player in town. The mysterious monster named Felusha. They're thinking of spilling the truth tea to the town, hinting that there's more drama yet to unfold. Out of the blue, they bump into an ancient stone tablet, triggering all sorts of questions. Our crew goes on a quest to decode these mysteries, connecting the dots to the dragon hunt. It's like a puzzle party, blending the everyday with the extraordinary. They uncover an old tablet with the magic word treasure, kicking off an island-wide treasure hunt. The gang dives into the hunt, cracking codes and uncovering clues that lead them to Kirkin Island. The treasure map finally spills the beans, pointing straight to Kirkin Island. They piece together clues and unveil the real treasure, an ancient tree spitting out Kirkin fruit seeds. And guess what? These seeds are like gold, crucial for water collection and packing a punch of historical awesomeness. Now, things get a bit philosophical. The gang's journey teaches them that treasures aren't always sparkly and expensive. Nope, life's treasures are hidden in the everyday, reminding them to cherish the simple stuff. The story ends with a shout-out to our main gal, Ryza. Her ordinary farmer's daughter life in Rosenboden gets a facelift with alchemy, friends, and the realization that life's real treasures are found in the everyday moments. A round of applause for the girl who turned the ordinary into extraordinary. We were done,